Currently standing in our Viking 2188 AT12N, quite the mouthful. This is actually about a 2.4 or 2.5 maturity bean.
We numbered it thinking that it was a 2.1 maturity and we were wrong. It's actually more like a 2.4 maturity. And so you have to be careful of that with its northerly movement because it is a very full season soybean, a 2.4 or even sometimes acting like a 2.5.
We've had very good luck with this bean. It's been a very popular bean, quickly became one of our best sellers.
It also has aphid tolerance, and that's especially a big deal for organic farmers, but even conventional farmers can get some benefits from that aphid tolerance because it has but two genes that confer aphid tolerance, and it has really, really noticeably higher yields in the presence of aphids. So if you have a year where aphids become a big problem, this is a soybean you will not have to spray with insecticides most of the time. It's going to live through that critical period when the aphids are doing the most damage. It also assists nematode resistance.
Very tall, bushy bean, very high yielding.
The one thing to look out for with 2188 is that it is not a good standing soybean at harvest. When the leaves start to drop in mid-September, you'll see this soybean lean a lot and look pretty messy out there. Once all the leaves comes off and it reaches full maturity, it does stand up and you're able to combine it without a problem, but it does look pretty ugly there for a couple of weeks in the fall. It's a yellow hilum soybean, or some people say a clear hilum soybean, with medium protein levels, so it has some utility in the food soybean markets. A lot of soybean companies recognize this soybean and will buy it and use it in food grade channels.
So don't be fooled by the food grade designation on this one. It does yield.
In our internal replicated trials, there's years where it's been either the top yielder or the second highest yielding bean out of 50 or 60 varieties, including lots of checks from large companies. So excellent top end yield. And that combined with that yellow hilum make it a very attractive option for farmers that can plant a 2.3 or a 2.4 maturity soybean.